So I pooped myself on the podcast today.
I pooped myself on the podcast.
Yeah, that's kind of cool. I like it.
Kind of when bounces around. When I think about you, I poop myself.
Oh, that's so sexy.
I cracked myself up.
You see what I mean? It becomes funny. Poop and second grade humor.
Oh, it hurts.
I'm losing the match battle.
Stop trying. So you killed it. It's dead now.
It is
Carl
not
has
dead.
A lighter.
Yes, give me actual
for the love
fire,
of all creatures, great and small.
Lighter explodes in her hand.
Why?
At least she has fire now.
Why have you forsaken me, oh God of things that are, you know, whatever.
You gotta make sure you read it. Fuck communism.
Got it.
Yeah, fucking chicken sandwich communist bitch.
You fall in love with capitalism, but you fuck communism.
Is it bad that I still eat a Chick-fil-A?
No.
That you did
only
you what?
Only after you digest it and have to shit, but other than that,
I have the
fun.
Sudden urge to eat there more often now.
Well, it's bad because it's really shitty food. It's not good
it
for
is.
Your body.
I really don't even like it. But it's
good.
The fact that
you're doing it out of irony. You're
yes,
a Chick-fil-A hipster.
I'm being spiteful now. That's I'm sticking it to the man.
Oh my God, I love gay people. I hope this was a girl chicken I'm eating right now.
See, that's what I would do if I was trying to.
Actually, chickens are girls, aren't they? Because roosters are the yeah.
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 Shut up.
And plus, you know, if it's like
100% rooster meat, it just sounds gross. Like yeah. It's gonna be a little rooster cock
if,
or something.
You know, because if they sold rooster at that restaurant, I would order cock all day.
Yeah,
yeah, like
cock
giant cock sandwich.
Chick-fil-A, I love sticking their cock in my mouth. Chick-fil-A. Our chicken's 100% homosexual. No homosexual chickens were harmed during the making of the Chick-fil-A. Our chickens are all straight chickens. Hey, 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 you're listening to That's Life, the podcast designed with your laughter in mind. So please sit back, relax, and prepare to be entertained.
That's life.
And
that's
we're back. Woo! We got some exciting people here with us today, as you heard. We got Pete. We've got
exciting I am.
We've got Jen, who's got all kinds of exciting stories.
Jen is back.
Yeah, that is correct. Yay. In full red hair glory here, looking a little sun cooked.
I am a little sun cooked. My red is fading, though. You missed when it was red.
It doesn't look like it's fading. It looks like it leaked into your skin, because now your skin's all red. Don't you know white people can't go in the fucking sun?
My skin is tan, thank you. If you look at it in the right light, I have a very nice golden glow.
Is it under all the blistery white person skin that's falling off because you put it in the fucking sun?
Yeah, pretty much. Hey, yeah. I have a pool in my backyard. And I
Me
have
too.
This thing where I know that they put the stuff in cans and you can spray it on your body and it saves your skin from
mean
the
DDT?
Sun. No, I was actually referring to sunblock.
Sounds delicious.
You know, that does sound like a Chick-fil-A meal. I'd like a DDT, please. DDT chicken. DDT chicken.
And then Ric Flair comes out and owns your face off the counter.
Very nice. I almost didn't get that reference. Good, good.
Three other people are laughing right now, well, I'm sure.
Well, that's
I don't even know if Ric Flair does a DDT at all, but it was
Pete,
the first wrestler that came into my mind.
That's half our audience, so you know, we tested well. No, we're actually getting a lot more people listening, which is super awesome. A shout out to all of our new friends who are listening and laughing.
That's because they're all trying to picture me and hoping that if they picture me naked, I'm actually hot.
That might be some of it. I don't know.
Can't put those pics on Facebook.
Oh, yeah. No. That's
dig a little harder, people.
It ain't that kind of show.
Oh, trust me. There's probably something out there.
But
it's the internet, you know.
Yeah, yeah. It's, I can't. Jeez, I can't.
Of course, the internet's failing the internet. Me at the moment, finding a picture for episode 28, but whatever.
Well, what was the title for 28?
Sweaty
storms and panties.
Oh,
you'd
yeah.
You'd think it'd be easier. And I thought I'd get a lot more cock, but no.
We found a lot of sweaty cooters, though.
Wow.
But none of them in a rainstorm.
No,
I'm disappointed.
No rainstorms.
We found a lot of sweaty cooters. I think we found a show title. No, trust me. I know what this show title is going to be.
Oh, okay.
Oh, my God. Okay, so let's do our what's new.
Yeah.
Let's start with ladies first. No, let's start with Pete. We're going to save you for last.
Yeah, because okay. You have probably the best what's
yours is,
yeah.
And probably the biggest.
Right.
So.
My what's new is really uninteresting because... fucking had rocking the fabulous abscess tooth.
Oh yeah,
it was worse.
Pete's hurting.
It was worse yesterday. Where it looked like I got punched in the eye. Today I woke up and looked like a squirrel with Down syndrome. So that was cool.
I like to eat acorns. I call the gun. I'm going to climb a tree now.
Hey, Corky, come back here. That's not an acorn. It's a rock.
I wouldn't want my teeth for breaking.
So, yeah.
So that's been
Well, now that we've alienated all of our Down syndrome afflicted listeners.
Yeah, because I'm sure we have a lot of
And the squirrels.
Those.
Yeah, that's...
Fuck the squirrels. They shut off power in for everybody but me, apparently.
Which is incredible. Well, you just don't lose power.
I'm gifted. What can I say?
There's a bubble. It's around his house. There's a giant bubble.
He's got a Protoss pylon.
Yeah. I did cast all the proper runes.
Word.
If anybody's ever out of power, just go to Pete's house. He's got internet, electric
powers.
He's good.
It's like the electrics. He just does the electric slide, the electric youth hangout. The
electric boogaloo.
Yeah, it's everything.
It's so crazy. Like that.
Yeah, your mouth is, you definitely got some pain. Big ups for showing up for the show.
I can't let our fan down.
That is true. But actually, we have two fans, one by the air conditioner and one over
that's
there.
That's right. That one's a bigger fan than that one.
Yeah, well, you know, that one listens more. So anyway, that's the one with the Down syndrome.
Oh, it does look kind of derpy.
So, big ups for you, though, for showing up.
That's and a bonus I've been getting, whereas last week I didn't have much for hours because there wasn't much for work. This week I have more hours than I ought to because
awesome.
Apparently they keep telling us there's plenty of work, but I keep finishing it all quick. They like that.
Employers usually do.
So,
well,
that's
awesome.
Going well. But yeah, like I said, nothing too terribly new. Oh, and cool. After in between last time we spoke and this time, we had a raid Thursday night last week for which I was belligerently drunk and pissed off half my guild, and it was hilarious.
Oops.
At the time.
Yeah, there seemed to be some
Most
sort of
them
of,
think it's funny now and are giving me shit for it. But
yeah, there seemed to be some emotional fallout floating through the guild. They were kind of like referencing it. I just got Netflix. That's my what's new. So I haven't really been playing anything as much as I used to. But now I figured out how to not do a full screen for Civilization 5.
Yes.
So now, and I just figured out how to squeeze it down. So now I'm actually watching old original Doctor Who's.
Oh, yeah.
While playing Civ 5.
Yeah, they have
Gives
all
me
that
a
good
geek
stuff.
Boner, dude. Wow. I saw Farscape. I'm like, oh my God, TNG.
Yep, they have all of Farscape.
And
on
I'm going to start college next week. Oh, how am I going to fit it all in? And I got 12s.
That's why you need another monitor.
Yeah, or a bigger one. But what's new? Tim is throwing up.
Cool.
Oh, wait,
no, that's bad.
He's always got some excuse.
It was at work. No, he
I'm
really was throwing up because
he doesn't
like,
love us anymore.
He just took off. I told him, I think he was going to try to soldier through, but I'm like, dude, Frank's not going to be here this week because he's like totally wants to be here for Frank episodes. It's going to be super awesome. I said, we got Jen. We got Pete. We possibly have Jen's boyfriend, but that's part of the what new why he's not here. So it looks like he got himself. And it was going to be real exciting. And I said, but we can live without you for this show. Just come in for the Big A Frank episode. It's going to be great.
Yeah, that'll be awesome.
And so what's new with Carl? Netflix, yeah.
Right.
Totally Netflix got talked good. Into it. Jason Narvez, a.k.a. Mason Jarvez, talked to me. He says, dude,
I
saw that.
For it through anywhere to get your free month or no?
I got my free month, and I just signed up too as well.
Oh,
like
because you can get... Like the free month for signing up, and then a lot of places around the net are like, sign up via us and get another 30
days. 3 months,
yeah.
So but
I got 2 free months.
Dude, it's like $8, and believe me, I'm getting that fucking money. So I'm actually going to hook up the Wii to the regular TV so I can watch it there so I can just fully game or whatever while I have that going on. So that's cool. Right. So much to explore. My brain... is just blown, dude. Completely blown. It's really exciting. Not that we're not sponsored by Netflix. I'm just like, and I'm sure every human being on the planet.
One day,
dude, I would be happy about that. Yeah, dude, I would be fucking totally down with that because I am just fucking loving it, dude. I'm like, wow, it's all here. Yay!
Yep.
So,
Netflix, if you're listening, we love you. Love us.
Love us, and we can love each other. Yeah. It'll be totally cool. Let's see, what else? Still working out. Went up in weight, like 10 pounds in everything. For the weightlifting, not my body mass.
You weigh yourself individually?
My goal is to get really fat.
My
arm
has gained 10 pounds. My leg has gained 10 pounds.
I was thinking of him. Here's what went on in my brain. If those of us have played Mech Warrior,
Oh, yeah.
On the loadout screen, yeah. Each little part has its own weight allotment. Yeah. So I put Carl's body on the Mech Warrior loadout screen.
I wish I could. I wish it was that easy. Keep doing missions. Cool, bigger arms.
He mashes P and all of his weights lift at the same time.
But I've actually noticed like muscle mass, like really, like in the chest. That's what I was focusing on. Chest and triceps is my main thing. And you know, when I'm like, I was like running and I was like, I'm like, whoa, I can fucking feel like more Carl meat, but not flabby, just like good. I'm like, yeah, it's working. Yay. So that's cool. And
I gotta start doing that.
That's everything. That's all I got. Now let's get to the really juicy stuff here.
Yeah. All been waiting for I have, many weeks now.
So many questions. So Jen actually got herself a boyfriend. Is that correct?
Jen
mail
did get
order
herself.
From Woodstown,
we'll go with Ireland.
I think.
Yeah, no. Yes, mail order from Woodstown.
From what I understand, awesome. I don't think he drinks enough to be from Ireland.
And he's a fan of the podcast, which is awesome.
He did really. I had him listen to the podcast. Awesome. He enjoyed it very much.
Tell him to subscribe and get a couple friends.
Yeah.
Yep.
Spread the funny.
He's very much looking forward to actually being a part of this.
Oh, yeah. It sounds like he needs to be cheered up. He's slitting his wrists, all kinds of crazy.
Well, we'll get to that. We will get to the whole wrist slitting thing.
Don't jump the shark, bro. So, whatever. Pick a phrase, put it there.
Yes.
Don't jump on it.
Don't jump something.
The actual boyfriend thing happened after this one night when I was all comfy in my pajamas and a friend of mine convinced me that I was going out that night when I was all comfy in my pajamas. I'm like, yes, typical Friday night. I'm going to sit on my ass on my couch and this is how I'm going to do this.
Yeah,
and
sounds about right,
she was guest bartending at a golf course in Woodstown.
Okay.
And so I went out there and then she's like, oh, let's go to the corner. And for everybody who doesn't know what the corner is, it is actually a bar, and it is on the corner of 40 and something.
All right, because I was thinking just going to the corner.
No,
I'm like, hey, you can pick up a lot of boyfriends that way.
I could, but
$20 at a time, even.
Yeah.
So we
20,
get
30, Pete. 30 at least.
Depends on where you. I was averaging between, you know,
she's
a couple blocks.
She's
down
an
the road
amateur
for a dollar.
Podcaster. She's an amateur podcaster. She can command the higher prices.
All right, I haven't been shopping recently, Carl, who is so wise in the prices of prostitutes.
Hey, look, I investigate every facet of podcasting now. In case we have
do you guys have the podcasting discount?
Podcasting pro. Just drop the name. That's Life. She'll give you $10 off, whatever you need. So yeah,
what's a CJ?
So, yeah, so you went to the corner, to the bar.
So I went to the corner, went to
the... And a guy walked
the
in.
The corner bar, no.
A I guy like how the corner
in,
bar
the wind
is on...
started blowing, and the lights flickered a little bit. No.
I like how the corner is actually literally on the corner of Route 40, and that only makes sense to people that live in Jersey.
It makes sense. Oh, yeah, Route 40.
Because it makes that stupid right-hand turn towards Cowtown.
It's like straight road.
One
straight
road has
and
a
one turn
at a light. Even
that's not the only place that Route 40 is retarded, because it's also retarded in Malaga, because you actually have to get off of 40, go on the Del C Drive, and then
or
get back on a 40. Yeah,
well, yeah,
so
yeah,
47.
Jersey's retarded.
Yeah. It's,
anyway, sorry.
Anyway,
so kicking open the door, trumpets flare.
Yeah,
angels
trumpets
sing.
Flare the whole nine yards. Or in reality, I went up to my one friend to say hi to him, and he was talking to somebody, and then we started talking about tattoos and this
angel. Guy, sing and trumpets blare.
This guy impressed the hell out of me because he looks at my tattoo and he goes, oh, nice onk. And I was like floored, because 9 out of 10 guys who look at my tattoo, they go, nice anchor. And I'm like, anchor?
Wow, that's... How can you not know what an onk is?
You'd be amazed at how many people go, hey, nice anchor. I'm like, really, fucktard?
Cause wings
that's,
make it look like an anchor.
Yeah, I'm really into Popeye the Sailor Man.
I understand the shape of it looks like an anchor. Yes, I understand.
No, it doesn't. It looks like an honk.
Okay, well, okay. Most
that's only if you're using your
this.
Eyes to translate symbols into thoughts.
Oh, yeah.
So I start talking to this guy.
Lady in Red comes on. Lady in Red.
And, okay, now my normal tasting guys
I danced
is,
with somebody to that song once.
Everyone has danced with somebody to that song. That's how everyone knows. It's not because it's a good song. It's just, it comes on, you're like, hey.
I think she was a girl, too.
Is that an anchor on your arm?
Yeah.
Let's dance. Pete, no! Creepy Pete! So, yeah.
That's what I do.
Yeah, so figures out it's not an anchor.
Yeah, so we start chit-chatting and everything. Now, mind you, my normal tasting guys tends to go towards the heavier set guys. I like...
Like, do you mean like
like a the big shoulders, rawr.
No, not like I take steroids and I pick things up and put them
no,
down.
No, but just like guys that are like...
Hodor.
Yeah. Like you, we'll say.
Aw, wait, that was a TFJ, wasn't it? That was a technical fat guy joke.
I went straight for the Hodor. So.
Just built-ish. Yeah. But not like disgusting like, with the veins and every muscle fiber.
Exactly.
My wife told me I am not allowed to do that. I was like, why? And I like food too much.
And I like a little fluff on the belly. I like that. Oh, okay. And now this guy that I'm talking to and is actually kind of blowing my mind at this point.
Wait, hold on. You like guys the opposite of that?
Yes, I do, but her guy is the opposite of that.
My guy is the opposite
of that. He's too short for me, though.
He is 5'2" and weighs about the same amount as I do.
All right. Well, so, that's good if you're like on a seesaw. It's boring, but okay. You just like toss like a 1 pound weight between each other. Wee.
So
they're catching.
They're
like
both
an
too short to reach the ground, so they're just stuck.
They're right? Just stuck. What
we
do?
Just hover there.
Fuck! This is a physics problem we can't solve.
We just need someone to come over and have a threesome so we can get off this thing. Either that, or throw us an anchor or an onk.
Or an onk, anything.
Oh God! So yeah,
an onk-shaped anchor.
Now, mind you, I'm wearing 5-inch wedges. Wedges are high heel shoes that are solid. They don't have a separate heel.
For our non-female, non-gay.
Oh, yes. AKA hooker shoes. I dated a stripper once, and I just would come in, and she was such a mess. I was like tripping over hooker shoes. I'm like, would you just pick up your hooker shoes? We have a closet. I set it up so you can have all your hooker shoes there. No, look, I got these. I'm Wonder Woman. Okay.
Okay, so now mind you, I also meet this guy on Friday the 13th.
Whoa.
Yes.
And he knew what an ankh was?
And an anchor? And an anchor. Holy he knew the shit. Difference between the two.
Who are you who are so wise in the ways of science?
An ankh.
So anyway. So
I don't know why. That's just making me laugh.
From the back of the bar, she's like ever. Up front, like, who knows what this is?
Churches.
First one to get it right gets to sleep with me.
What else sinks in water? An ankh. An anchor. Duh. I'm sorry. We are totally interrupting this great story being, well, ridiculous.
That's kind of what we do.
Of course, I'm at a bar. I'm drunk. I meet guy. What goes through my head?
Fucking
cock.
Oh, I'm totally going to get fucked tonight. You know what
freaks me out?
Tonight.
I got to pause this again. Why do girls get happy about that?
Why don't or why do?
Why don't women understand this simple fact? You walk up to a guy and go, let's fuck. The guy's going to say,
okay.
Yes. They always act like it's a big accomplishment. I'm going to get some ass tonight.
Like she had to try.
Yeah, that would be like an Arab going, I found some sand in the desert. You know, it's like... So... I just had to ask that question. I know it's rhetorical. You won't have an answer. No woman ever has.
I don't have an answer.
But I'm happy for you. I'm all pumped up now because you're getting some ass. So, go
so
ahead.
This is what's going through my head. I'm getting laid tonight. This is what I need. I need a nice one-night stand.
He's going to tap that anchor.
I'm going to tap that anchor, and then I never have to worry about this again. He's cute. He's sweet.
I got fucked once. I can check it off my bucket list. Had sex. Check.
With an anchor.
With an anchor.
The weirdest dildo ever. So heavy.
It's not an anchor. It's an ankh.
So it turns out we actually have a lot in common, and we spend the majority of the night. Okay, there was sex. There was some really good sex.
Yeah!
Right on the bar.
But there was a lot.
Yeah! It gets to Steven Tyler. Yeah, baby! Gets all excited. Sorry. It has to happen.
Okay. Yeah, I got to take a
smiling.
Second.
Oh, yeah, sure.
So much right now.
So, yes, the sex definitely did happen.
You threw your uncles in the air and went to town.
Exactly.
Oh, yeah. Oh, Pete, I went there. Does your tooth hurt yet?
Oh, God damn it. Smiling hurts so bad.
But we end up talking a lot
so
of night.
So all this happened at the bar?
No, all this happened back at his house.
Okay.
It was much funnier in my head when it was happening on the bar.
Yeah, it did not happen on the bar. That would have been awesome.
Kind of Coyote Ugly. Actually, if that happened in Coyote Ugly, it would have been a better movie.
But once again, that would have been awesome, but how could I ever make that happen? Here's how you make it happen. You go, want to fuck? But it has to be on the bar. All right.
Well, usually the bartender might pull King of England rules and go first round, but I, you know.
And it happens. That's how easy it happens. I've always had this fantasy, and there were thousands of men lining up ready to make it happen.
I think that happened. Debbie Does Dallas, right? Yes.
Yeah, but I'm still once again perplexed that anyone would think it's a challenge. Get the news out. It's easy to get dick. Just spread the news. Tell them all.
Yeah.
Just don't make them like do like the like have a police lineup. There's like four anchors and one honk. And yeah, that brings us to, that, so I remember to do our next super funny segment. We got some really great weird news.
It's the weirdest.
Weird news coming to you.
That's a New Jersey word, by the way.
What, coming? I thought everybody used that.
No, use.
Oh, use.
Yeah, I was talking to Kent about that, actually.
It's Y-O-U-Z-E or something.
Like, yeah, use. It's like use.
Use guys.
Use, but with a Y in the front. some of which is brought to you by way of Chuck Shepard's newsoftheweird.com, some from The Smoking Gun, and some from random sorted APR news sources scattered throughout the interwebicon. So give some love. Check out Chuck Shepard's News of the Weird and The Smoking Gun, because they got some funny shit there. This first item is titled, "Hey, how's that Canada Care working out for you?" Fern Cooper, 65, and 13 other cataract surgery patients arrived at Ontario's Oakville Trafalgar Hospital on June 25th to learn that they would not receive the usual anesthesia because the hospital had decided to schedule an experimental day.
Hey, come on down. Oh, it's Friday, experimental day.
We all wear gonzo shirts and just don't use any anesthesia.
That's where everybody just kind of makes out with everybody else and see what feels right.
Yeah, Chick-fil-A's out front protesting. To evaluate how unsedated patients respond to... Oh, sorry, Pete.
No, it's okay. You,
Pete's having an experimental day for his mouth. The Ontario Health Insurance Plan had recently cut anesthesiologist fees. So you're pretty much fucked. So yeah, how's that working out? A topical numbing gel plus doctor's reassurances. Thank you.
Assurance. It's like insurance, but nowhere near as good.
Yeah, no insurance. Well, here's our reassurance. Were provided, but Cooper,
how are those words working out for you?
Previously diagnosed with severe anxiety, told the Toronto Star of the terror she felt when, fully awake, she watched the surgeon's scalpel approaching and then cutting her fucking eyeball.
Well, the upside is there's no nerves in your eye, so it's not like she would have felt it anyway.
No, there is no fucking upside to that. That fucking sucks, and you know it.
Well, I mean, okay. Well, yeah, I mean, it's terrifying. You said that.
But to make it better,
she wouldn't actually felt it.
This next one's called, "Hey, how's that witch doctor medicine working out for you?"
It's experimental day at the witch doctor hut. Sorry, we don't have any of that cool frog potion
Hold on, I think all witch doctor medicine is experimental.
Oh no, it's been tried over bajillions of years.
We got liver cancer, corn husks, and voodoo dolls. Enjoy. Christianity has grown in acceptance recently in Ratanakiri Province, Cambodia, according to a June report in the Phnom Penh Post. To 80% of the population has...
My usual newspaper?
Well, yeah, it's like the Washington Post. Giving up the traditional Theravada Buddhism, which is mixed with animism, as being too demanding. According to local officials, traditional priests typically prescribe expensive offerings such as slaughtered buffalo as the price of improving a relative's health, said one convertee. With the money saved using Western medicine instead of traditional sacrifices, she was able to build a house for her family.
Holy shit. So you could market religions like you can fucking car insurance.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Like from Allstate.
Christianity progressive. We'll look at all your other religion sacrifice costs and compare them and give you the best price.
We need something. Christianity is there. Poop. And they magically appear as Jesus.
Wow.
That'd be awesome.
With a new religion. And a sandwich. And a really hot gardener.
Done.
Oh no, the gardener's a dude.
Sorry, I'm gay. Haha. Sorry, Chick-fil-A. This next one's called Professor Creepy and Frapping 101.
Hey, look, when he says he loves everyone,
he loves everyone. He hung out with 12 dudes.
Just putting that out there. Also had 7 wives.
Hey, 7 wives for one Jesus. That works for me. According to a June lawsuit by a former student, Western Nevada's college's course in human sexuality was so over the top that it might be described as a collection of instructor Tom Kubistant's erotic fantasies about college-age kids. Among Kubistant's
they're not high school kids.
Demands, according to KR, were keeping a masturbation journal and ramping up the activity to twice the student's pre-course level. Disclosing one's uninhibited sexual fantasies that in some cases were described by the instructor to the class at large, and conducting discussion groups on the uses of sex toys and lubricants. By the fifth week, KR claimed, Kubistant had abandoned his schedule of topics and began to dwell extensively on the female orgasm. Kubistant's instructions appeared to fit the faculty's handbook's definition of sexual harassment.
Well, it is a company thing.
Yeah, sexual harassment. It's a company function.
Function, that's what.
Oh my God, that actually made me think of something. I think the last time I was here, we had a conversation about the fact that I had never.
Maybe you should take this guy's course.
You did it?
It happened!
Oh shit, I'm abandoning my mic for a high five.
It happened!
Well?
Gymnast sex is awesome!
Well?
It was fantastic, of course.
Like a whole body.
Full on the whole
you
nine yards.
Again in 2 hours.
He didn't do it just once. He has made me do it like.
Good for you.
He's phenomenal. I can never get rid of him.
No wonder you were like, you're not dying now, man.
Pretty much.
I need you to live.
I need that hand healed too.
Yeah. Well, goodness gracious. I guess he doesn't necessarily. This next one has a little subsection within this segment called Mila's. Or moms I'd like to arrest.
I was about to say, like, Kunis?
This first one's called It's a Family Business. Alleged drug dealer Jesus Pepe Fuentes, age 37, was arrested. No, I prefer to think of a Jesus doing this. Was arrested in Chicago in May after his mother botched a heroin pickup for him. Fuentes,
good job, mom.
Eager to catch a concert by the rapper Scarface, sent his mother instead to gather the 10-kilo drop.
Wow.
Is kilo a lot? That's what I was going to ask you, metrics thing. How would that, is that like an ounce or?
No.
A pound?
Kilo is a brick. Like,
dude, 15? Holy shit. She collected the drugs, but the entire shipment was lost when she failed to use a turn signal and was stopped by the police.
Derp.
From the Chicago Tribune. This next one's called At Least She Won't Ground You for Your Report Cards. Catherine Venusto, age 45, was arrested in July and charged with breaking into the computer system of the Northwestern Lehigh School District in Pennsylvania, where she formerly worked.
It's Lehigh, but that's okay.
Oh. Lehigh. I think it's an Indian word. And changed the records of her two children. And, while at it, was reading private emails of 10 school officials. Venusto allegedly switched a daughter's F grade to an M for medically excused, and one grade for her overachieving son from a 98 to a 99. That's our Mila section. I don't know why you would even change it from a 98 to a 9. Why not 100?
Yeah. Why not?
Maybe she didn't want people to like get
like
suspicious.
110. Just go crazy, crazy.
Okay.
I thought she was going to change it backwards. Oh, he's achieving too much. I'm going to make that like a 92.
I don't want to look too smart. This next one's called Winning. Chicago staged its annual gun buyback program in June. A $100 gift card for every fireman. Every fireman you turn in, you get a $100 police gift card.
That's a fucked up way to win the football game, eh?
Amidst its worst homicide epidemic in years, in which 259 have died on city streets. In the first six months.
The rest
months,
of them died in other odd places around the city. In the park, on other buildings.
259 people died in the first 6 months of 2012. God damn.
In the streets.
Mm. Hey,
that's just the streets, man.
However, the
fucking
program
tripping on dead people
appears to be inadvertently a win-win project for both anti- and pro-gun forces. The city reported that 5,500 guns were removed from circulation, bringing the total to 23,000 since the program was inaugurated. Now, you got to mind, these guns can be in any condition, like totally just like a piece of a fucking gun barrel, a rusted receiver. It doesn't matter. You get a $100 fucking thing.
Okay.
On the other hand, 60 of this year's guns were handed in by a local pro-gun organization, Guns Save Lives, which promised to use its gift cards to buy ammunition for a National Rifle Association-supported shooting camp for underprivileged kids. So see?
That's kind of awesome.
Yeah. Winning.
Winning.
This next one is, I think, one of the funnier weird news stories I've heard of.
This is the one we've all been waiting for.
Yes. This next one,
Big Mama Jamma,
is called Pimpin' Ain't Easy Unless Yo Gots the Rule Book.
I like it already.
Oh, yes.
I was just talking about how pimpin' ain't easy today.
Well, after this, you'll know how to do it.
Oh, good.
During a raid on the Long Island home of an alleged pimp, police recovered a handwritten list of 10 management rules to follow when turning women out on the street.
Get ready, Pete. That tooth is gonna ache.
Hold on.
Go ahead. Oh, I'm going to do it now. Get that iced tea.
Let me
get
this drink before it comes out my nose.
In announcing today's arrest of 8 defendants for their alleged roles in a prostitution and heroin ring,
allegedly,
Suffolk County prosecutors released a copy of Rules to the Game of Hose.
Oh, I will find links to this.
With 3 exclamation points.
Was hose spelled with a Z by any chance?
H-O-E-Z. Two is the number two.
Yo, that bitch puts the easy in hose.
The list, which investigators allege was prepared by Stephen McDaniel, was recovered from the Karam home he shares with Sandra Russell. McDaniel, 29, and Russell, 26, were allegedly the ringleaders of the narcotics and prostitution operation.
Allegedly.
Additionally, Russell has been accused of running the prostitution ring from a residence where she paid hookers in heroin, which I guess is a decent commodity to
exchange.
That's not bad.
For that.
I don't know. That's kind of fucked up. Heroin's cheaper than weed from what I understand.
According to Suffolk County District Attorney Thomas Spada, the hose rules was, quotes, a document from Stephen McDaniel outlining for Russell his management advice on the operation of a prostitute business.
Oh, and tell me you have the rules.
I just happened to have
not only the rules, it is the actual list.
Yes. It's a picture of a photocopied picture of the actual list of confiscated from this alleged prostitution.
Yes,
ring.
Now I'm going to read it to you. I'll throw in when he makes the any spelling bizarrities because these rules are definitely, I guess, sound for the game of hose. But not for the game of grammar or English or spelling.
It's a, you know, it's a game for pimps, by pimps.
By pimps? Okay, yeah. You're right. No English professors mixed in there. So let's go number one on the rules to the game of hose. Maybe we'll give it a shot. I've got a few beats laid by.
I can make it. Oh, yeah. I know it was.
Number one. Okay. And we actually have a lady here, so she can let us know if this would...
I get to be the hoe.
That's great. I think that's going to be her sound bite. Number one, always make them need and depend on you so you have power over them. And in parentheses, power is control, in case you were wondering. So you didn't get confused like electricity.
I was never really sure about that, but thank you.
Okay.
Unstoppable power.
Number two. No, this guy definitely ain't the emperor.
Please tell me don't forget the baby powder is on there.
Line.
What's that?
I said, please tell me don't forget the baby powder is on there.
Number two. Make them understand that you don't need them. They need you. And they are replaceable. Never let them know, N-O, if you need them deep down inside. So, you know, don't be too emotionally available for them.
Yeah.
Number three, never let no, as in N-O, number one, no one, get away with sneaking anything. Because once they feel they can get army, they will always scheme.
Aha. So, this guy's a real professor.
He's kind of thought out. Is. Number four.
Number four.
No matter how much you like or care for one, the number one, or any of them, don't trust none of them.
Don't trust them hoes.
Parentheses. Like Scarface. Who do I trust? Me. That's who.
Can't trust some hoes.
That's nice, though. I like that he's got footnotes. He's quoting his sources.
Yep. Yeah, well, you know, that's good. And Scarface is a good one to quote.
Oh, I would model my life after this any day. Here is a lighter. See? She needs me. See That's how I right. got that working? Oh, you want this? Here you go.
I don't need you, but I'm going to...
It just lands on the couch every time.
Yeah, huh? That's how I rolls. Number five. Always stay 2 steps... The possessive form of it, the contraction. 2 steps ahead of the game you have them playing.
Okay.
I guess, like, for example, if it's family night and you're playing a board game, you want to stay two steps ahead of them if you're playing Monopoly or maybe Uno or something.
In the game of pimping life, I spin the wheel. Bitches. So, get the fuck back in the car.
So pimping is like a wheel of fortune?
Yeah.
You ever played a game of life?
No.
It's got a wheel. You spin it. It's got numbers. Oh, so you know how many spaces you go.
No, I really don't like
that. I always end up with no job and 20 kids.
Well, you'd be just like a
there you go. Yeah. Number six. Don't let them know all your plans. Possessive. But always try to know theirs.
Ah.
Possessive. Number seven. Possessive is apostrophe S, just in case you were wondering. Number seven.
So it's
yes. And it's theirs, as in over theirs.
Right. Yeah. I'm about to say, because I thought it was theirs, like, you know, the actual pronoun.
No. Number six.
Oh, shit. Yeah, because that would have been right.
That would have been grammatically
good
correct.
Good job, brain.
Number seven. Make sure you own their minds, possessive. Bodies, possessive, and souls, possessive, parentheses, and test it out every often to make sure.
Oh, his logic is dizzy.
Yeah, I'm afraid if I finish this list, I'll become a prostitute. Number eight.
We'll be writing in letters to wherever this is from. We gotta let these people go. I needs my daddy.
I'll say, Mr. McDonald, I need my heroin, please. I've been turning tricks furiously.
And other dude's mom totally fucked up the last drop.
Yeah. Number eight. Keep your B.I., I guess that's short for B.I.A.C.H., on the low as possible when it comes, possessive, to family and haters, possessive.
Fucking haters.
Parentheses. Because you can't trust none of them. That seems to be a recurring theme.
See rule number whatever it was.
That's number...
Scarface. Rule yes. Scarface.
Rule number Scarface. Number nine. Always try to know, N-O, what's going on. Parentheses. You know, obviously, he's not just going to leave it there.
Right, yeah.
Make them tell on each other.
Oh, snap. It's like a reality show.
Do you feel bamboozled yet, Jen, at all?
No, okay. I'm learning a lot over
bamboozled,
here.
Bamboozled, hoodwinked.
Because you can't trust hoes.
Obviously.
You can't trust none of them.
You got to make them tell on each other. Number 10. And this one is to let you know he's got a heart. He's a pimp with a heart, okay?
Pimp with a heart and tooth of gold.
Number 10. Number 10.
Oh, God.
I gotta stay in character here.
Gotta get it out.
Oh. All right, number 10.
Didn't mean to pin slap your game.
Please. Quite all right. Well, I'm gonna add a number 9.5. Don't step on another pimp when he's trying to read the list of pimping.
Sorry, I wonder if this is Cat Williams' same set of rules.
Jen, you should be telling on Pete right now.
Oh, I got it. I'm writing it all down.
Okay, number 10.
Number 10, here we go.
Give respect when respects, possessive, do.
Parentheses.
Follow these rules and yo should be Gucci.
Say what you want about the pants. The code is Gucci.
Say what you want, but the code is Gucci.
Or whatever it was. I think that's backwards. What you want about the coat, but the pants is Gucci.
The pants is Gucci.
Well, I actually learned a lot from this segment since my boyfriend wants me to start pimping him out because we're both broke.
Well, there you go.
So now I know how to treat him. I got to slap him
because the
a
bed
bit.
Broke?
They're both
no,
broke.
We're both broke.
Oh.
The bed probably might break from the sounds of it.
Well, there you go. Yeah.
Nah.
Yeah, window's
no,
already broken.
No bed
that's
frame.
Enough.
Well, you taught him a lesson, so, you know, he's not going to be getting loud anymore. You threw him through that plate glass window.
That's right.
Yep. I got to keep my hoe in place.
Oh, yes. Yes, that's absolutely.
Right. You got to learn.
Exactly. That you run a tight ship.
Bitches got to know.
That's right.
That's right. Show respect.
Yeah.
Respect to your fellow. Respects possessiveness to theirs over theirs is...
Parentheses.
Always the parentheses.
I do have to work on my grammar, though, if I'm going to be the pimp, because obviously my grammar
obviously you
too
speak
proper.
Far too well.
Yeah, you're far too articulate.
Yeah, I got to work on that.
Parentheses. Yo needs to step yo speak game up. Yo.
Yeah. Because when you're talking to people and you use the word reciprocate and they all give you that dumb sort of, I don't get it, look.
We've got two more exciting stories here.
Oh, there's one.
That wasn't the last one. That should have been the last one.
Well, I wanted to have that in circulation when we got these next two.
I see. Setting us up for more
Pippin. Oh, yes. This next one's called The Siren's Call of Booty.
Pippin don't stop, baby.
Yes, Pippin may not be easy. Pippin ain't easy, but it will be if you follow those simple rules.
That's right.
The 18-year-old Floridian, Aaron Morris, is sitting in a Broward County jail cell due to poor impulse control.
Oh.
Specifically, Morris is accused of groping a woman's buttocks outside a dressing room at a Walmart in North Lauderdale. The teenager was arrested shortly after the incident Thursday evening. During questioning by law enforcement, Morris admitted to grabbing the victim's rear end and provided an explanation of sorts.
He likes big butts and he cannot lie?
Well, that's implied. They'll be in the parentheses. Quote.
Parentheses, you other brothers can't deny.
Her booty looks so good.
How good was it?
I just couldn't resist touching it. End quote.
Oh, that's a good looking booty.
Locked up in lieu of $1,000 bail, Morris has been charged with touch or strike / battery, which is a misdemeanor in Florida. The last one is called Some Motherfuckers Ain't Got No Game.
Oh, damn. Well, 10 simple rules, and they can have all day game.
The 41-year-old Florida man, Tony Gustin. Oh, I said there was two stories. There's actually three. Was at a courthouse in Bradenton yesterday morning for an appearance on a minor traffic incident. While in the elevator, Gustin struck up a conversation with a woman there on a child support matter. As the 19-year-old exited the elevator, Gustin allegedly, quote, reached out with his left hand and grabbed her left breast and squeezed it, end quote. He told her, thank you and have a nice day.
At least he was polite.
The woman reported the incident to a caseworker who sought to track down the elevator groper. After Gustin was located on the courthouse's sixth floor, a second woman approached instigators to
investigators.
That's the word I'm like. Do you know how hard it was to read that in pimp language?
Yeah, you're all
my
fucked
tongue
up
is now. All pimped the fuck out. Wow.
Bitch slapped the gold right off his teeth.
So as they were looking for this guy, second woman approached to report that he had just masturbated in front of her.
Whoa.
After being handcuffed and read his Miranda rights, Gustin denied the group, claiming he was alone in the elevator. As for the second woman, he acknowledged that he had, quote, called a girl over to him because he thought he knew her, end quote. While admitting that his hands were in his pants, Gustin said, quote, I had an itch, end quote.
Yeah, and apparently he was scratching it.
When Officer Debbie Perry then asked why he would call someone over while itching his penis, Gustin had a simple explanation, quote, because I thought she might itch it for me. The unemployed Gustin was immediately booked into Manatee County Jail on a misdemeanor battery count. He is being held in lieu of $750 for his courthouse antics. I don't know if exactly if you call them antics.
Well, yeah. What else are you supposed to do after you grip somebody? I mean,
I guess apologize, go home and spank it.
Get their number.
Well,
masturbate in public.
Buy him a drink.
Yeah, exactly. He skipped that whole going home thing and just took care of the issue.
Filled a breast. I'm in court and I'm just going to masturbate in public.
They catch me. I ain't got to go far.
Yeah, there you go. Good. See, he had a plan. In parentheses. This final.
Parentheses. Keep your elevator bitches in line.
This final story is called Bacon. Why did it have to be bacon?
Uh-oh. I love
it's
bacon.
It's always bacon.
Well, so did the Georgia woman, Lonisha Shafaya Appling, age 26.
What?
Who was so determined to shoplift beer, bacon, cheese, and chicken wings from a Piggly Wiggly that she punched, spit at, and pepper sprayed store workers who confronted her as she tried to flee the supermarket Wednesday afternoon. Here's a lovely picture of this rotund miscreant.
She looks like she needs some bacon.
She looks like she's had a lot of bacon.
Yeah.
She makes me wonder, do they pay like hookers by the pound in Georgia or what?
So.
Appling pictured in that.
It should probably be by the kilo if it's a hooker ring.
The kilo would confuse people. Because for me, kilo equals ounce. See, I'm all mixed up now.
Yeah.
Those
are really heavy, big ounce.
She allegedly hid the items worth $88.27 in a canvas bag. She attempted to check out, only putting one item on the counter, according to the worker. Quoted in the Athens-Clark County Police Department report. Whoa, what a mouthful.
Yeah.
What a Piggly Wiggly employee.
Piggly Wiggly!
Who had been tipped to the pilfering by a shopper, asked Appling about the concealed items. She tried to exit the store. After worker Jonathan Orr tried to stop Appling, she pulled out some pepper spray and sprayed him in the fucking face. Appling kept spraying as several workers tried to keep her from fleeing. The 340-pound Appling had...
Holy shit.
She also allegedly punched Orr in the fucking face and then spit on the 28-year-old employee. As she successfully...
She knows how to be a pimp.
Oh, damn. Yeah, she pimp-slapped the whole goddamn store. I'll turn all you bitches out. Slap. Hey, Piggly Wiggly, what did Five Fingers say to the face? Slap. Bacon. As she bolted from the Athens store, Appling was dropping beer cans out of her purse like Johnny Appleseed.
Yeah.
But she held on to the bacon.
Back to her home.
At 340 bacon. At 340 pounds, how fast can you really bolt?
I don't know, but I guess she was like...
Usain Bolt, motherfucker.
By the power of bacon. Speed away. Bacon. they found her a block and a half later having a coronary. Bacon hanging out her mouth. Responding to a 911 call, an officer reported spotting, quote, a very large black female in a purple dress standing there screaming at two store employees who followed her outside the Piggly Wiggly, which was filled with a choking cloud of pepper spray and I'm sure some funk. Police then arrested Appling, whose rap sheet includes several prior shoplifting convictions and an outstanding arrest warrants in three separate Georgia counties.
That is outstanding.
I don't think she had a choice, though, because it sounds like she occupied three separate Georgia counties at once. Police prepared an inventory of the items Appling sought to swipe. 5 packages of cheese, 8 cans of Coors Light, a bottle of vegetable oil, chicken wings, and 5 packages of bacon. God damn!
She was having a party that night.
No,
man.
It sounds like... Look
that's
at her.
What sounds like dinner for her, yeah, by really. The picture. Holy shit. I'm surprised it wasn't like 16 sticks of butter, too.
Well, she moving that mash, she burned through most of that while she was making her escape.
Yeah, well, at least of Coors Light. Yeah.
As first reported by the Athens Banner-Herald, she was charged with a variety of crimes, including aggravated assault, theft, simple battery, and disorderly conduct in the shoplifting of bacon. While in police custody, Appling told a police officer to add whatever charges he wanted, quote, because she was going to plea bargain, and half of the charges would be dropped anyway. Well, I guess like so many cans of Coors Light.
Coors Light, yeah.
According to the report, she also asked Officer Nathaniel Franco if her arrest would make the police blotter, requesting that the police make his report, quote, more interesting, so that her arrest would make the department's compendium of notable incidences.
Man, everybody, well, I'd say it's a notable fuck it is. Well,
yeah.
Holy shit, Shamu stealing beer and bacon.
Beer, bacon, cheese, and vegetable oil. Either she's going to have a delicious filling lunch or the weirdest sex ever recorded in Georgia history.
Oh, there was an image everybody did not need.
340 pounds of bacon covered. Yeah, the unemployed and now incarcerated Apple.
Get over here and lick this bacon and vegetable oil off my disgusting rolls.
Well, she needed the oil to fit the Coors Light cans inside.
Oh, God.
Inside her refrigerator, because it was packed. What did you think I was going to say, you perverts? God.
The booty hole.
The now incarcerated Appling, quote, also commented that store personnel should chase people like that because they could get themselves hurt. Or shoplifters could get busted.
Or winded.
And that is our weird-ass pimpin' news.
Yeah. Oh, and as a side note news. To help your understanding of a kilo...
Oh, yes. Okay.
1 kilogram is approximately 2.2 pounds.
Damn. So 10 kilos is like 1,000 pounds?
Yeah, yeah. Exactly. So the 15 dead keys that lady had was over 30 pounds of...
Jesus. Heroin. And he made his mom carry that around? I mean, even if it wasn't illegal, that's just some rude shit.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I know.
Skip the fucking scar cake.
Scar cake.
Entenmann's newest scar cakes. He's motherfucking delicious.
Say hello to my little donut.
Say hello to my delicious friend. Oh, yeah. Lord. I'm going to shoplift that next. It's a bacon.
Coming bacon flavor?
Yeah, so maybe she was doing it at the behest of her local pimp. Who can tell? He paid that bitch in bacon. Damn.
Yeah, it's like heroin dose.
Fuck the heroin. I want some bacon.
You best give me some onion rings.
And some goddamn oil.
Because they don't say oil down south. They say all.
All.
Which A-L. I actually tested someone on once. She had a southern accent.
Right.
And she said all. And I went, I'm sorry, what? All. All? All. All. Okay. So what do you, like what you put in a car? All. Okay. Do me a favor, say bowl. Bowl. Okay. Now say oil. Oil. Okay. Just checking.
That's like crayon.
That was, well, the first time I met her, he's married to her now, so it's like it's okay. But he just met her online, and she came up all the way from Kentucky. And the first thing I said, because I was drinking and, of course, obnoxious, he's like, yeah, she came up all the way from Kentucky. And I went, I said, oh, you're from Kentucky. And I said, oh, sorry about the war, dearie. And the first thing she said, when I first met you, I thought, what an obnoxious asshole. Yeah. And I was like, an ass what? Because, you know, I am an obnoxious asshole. But, yeah, so it's been a very exciting episode.
It has been.
We've had all kinds of interesting information. We've covered the Ten Commandments of Pimping.
Yep.
Have been covered. We've learned some important lessons. Always fuck a gymnast.
Always.
Gentlemen, know how to tell an anchor from an unk, because it could get you laid. And when punching a door, don't punch a window.
Why did 4 out of 5 or 3 out of 4 of those lessons all come from me?
Because you're here.
Okay.
And pimping ain't easy.
And pimping ain't easy. And we learned 10 lessons about pimping.
Yes.
That's right.
Which, Jen, you got to apply those.
I will apply them. I'm going to start working on my grammar first.
Here, I'm going to hand them off to you.
All right.
Reaching over.
There we go. All right.
Stretching and...
See, that's where the fart noise
That's where the fart sound comes in.
Having this will actually help me work on my grammar, too, since...
You can get the same grammar by spending any amount of time in an internet chat room, Facebook, World of Warcraft.
Yeah.
Let's see. My grammar's sucks.
Your grammar's sucks.
Yo, my grammar's be sucking.
All possessive.
All possessive, of course.
Yes. That was pretty good. Hose. Good episodes, possessive hose.
Yeah, boats and hose.
Boats. Now I gotta watch that. But gives us sort of an which is good to have.
I think so.
I need to be here a little bit more often than once every 2 months.
Yeah, definitely, definitely. You but you build up some exciting stories. You had an orgasm, which is several.
I got a boyfriend, I got orgasms,
a trip to the ER.
I got to watch an artery get sewn together.
Yeah, dude, it's a rich, full fucking couple of weeks for
figured
you.
Figured out I'm like fucking Wonder Woman.
You're like Wonder Woman?
I'm like Wonder Woman. Like dude, if you hadn't been there on Friday, I'm like fucking Wonder Woman.
You're
I
like
Wonder Woman. Up a house.
Okay, yes. Well, that's fucking awesome.
Yes.
And you had some snazzy shoes.
Ankh of truth.
Yeah, man. You could have lifted up an anchor.
Anchoring bitches.
Or an ankh.
Or an ankh. Well, ankhs are very easy to lift because they're small.
Well, it depends on the ankh.
Well, that's true. That's true. A big ankh. Some ankhs are bigger than others. That's true.
Depends on how much your sacrifice costs.
Yeah, it's not the size of the ankh. It's how you use it.
Something like that.
Now, that's the that we looked for. I think we got it.
Yeah.
So that... brings us to you've been listening to That's Life, a Baby Boy production, episode number
34.
Yes, it is. And thank you so much for listening. You can listen to any of the season 2 episodes for free at our YouTube channel, youtube.com/ That's Life Podcast.
Well, it is. Right here.
Yep. Yeah. To listen to or download any of the season 1 and season 2 episodes for free, check us out at thatslifepodcast.com. Be sure to subscribe, and...
subscribe.
That's right. For instant notification via email, whatever...
notification.
New episodes are posted.
That's That's right. And I'm supposed to say things like, go touch us in our funny places, which you should do. And you can find us on Facebook, facebook.com/thatslifepodcast. So go like us there, like us on YouTube, share this shit on other places that you happen to like sharing things on, tweet about it, send texts about it, email about it, write a letter, send it to your grandmother. Grandmothers love us. They do. So you should love us too.
And if you've enjoyed what you just heard, be sure to tell a friend, neighbor, or coworker, and help us to spread the laughter as far as we can.
Do it.
Do it. So from all of us here at That's Life, this is Biz.
This has been Pete. And that over there is
Jen.
And
this over here is Carl. Bidding you an adieu and adieu and a big pimpin'
adieu. Hose.
Hoes, bitches and hoes. Everywhere I goes, it's bitches and hoes.
Oh my God, the sex is so good. I got a sunburn. Oh,
this isn't sunburn. It's pillow burn.